I think rhythm is kind of the foundation and the compass point. It can change the nature of a song or the nature of a melody, and sometimes you can hear a piece of music and not understand the context of it till you hear a kick drum come in or till you hear the rhythm, and then that tells you what it dictates the song for you.
It's kind of hard to explain. It's kind of, you got to get like real scientific when you go into that type of stuff, because it's like, just conversation is rhythm.
I can speak the rhythms.
You know what I'm saying? People walking is rhythm.
Walking down the street.
Cars going by at the time that they go by is rhythm. You know what I'm saying?
Walking down the street.
Walking.
The speed I walked.
A direction.
Walking.
A compass point.
The speed I walk.
Talking.
I can speak the rhythms.
Just conversation is rhythm.
I can speak the rhythms, and so every composition that I've learned on the tabla, we have to learn how to speak before we play it. So for example, dina taka dina taka taka dina taka dina taka taka dina taka da tiri kita taka taka tiri kita da gira naga dina taka diri diri kita taka da tiri kita taka. That's how I count.
Talking.
Or even when I like walk.
Walking.
I try to walk in a certain BPM.
I think my favorite BPMs are in that 90 range.
I like 90, like 85, 90, 95.
I guess I do always gravitate towards 100.
Like hip hop, a lot of hip hop stuff is under 100.
And good old 120.
I love 120 BPM.
120 is a common tempo. It's a little slower.
It's a good one. Can't deny it.
I'm mostly triggered by something between 123 and 134 or something like this.
124.
And I also love 134.
134.
134.
For whatever reason, feels really good to me.
Actually, I even like 140.
When you get up in the 140s and 150, it's kind of like where everything is right now.
If I have 150 on my sampler, my DAW, it's usually me saying 75, but then I can, you know, put more information in a grid and make it still look clean.
I mean, my favorite noises from the city might probably be the alarm noises from police and fire department cars. You know, they just always work in any type of music I make.
A very classic choice would be a train on a train track. It's rhythmic in a very particular way.
I would say my favorite kind of rhythms are the ones that you hear in nature.
Nature.
Nature sounds, obviously.
Just the rhythm of like of a river, of a bubbling creek.
Can be very rhythmic and melodic and interesting and curious.
The tree swaying back and forth.
The rustling of leaves.
And like leaves, which I don't know if you would normally. Oh, weird. The power just went off in the whole house.
Wind.
Waves.
A waterfall,
a weird bird call, or
even geese sounds. I mean, it's all rhythm.
Birds and stuff, you know. It's a good question. I like it.
My friends always say that I'm like constantly singing. And if, especially if there's like some sort of rhythm happening, like the windshield wipers, I'll sing along. Oh.
Also windshield wipers, because I live in Portland and it rains a lot, so there's windshield wipers going in my car often, and they're so rhythmic, you know, just the
windshield wipers. Other car sounds.
Yeah, either your blinker on the car.
When you sit in a car and you want to turn to the right, you have to use the blinker.
That's the OG hi-hat pattern right there.
I'm inspired by everything around me.
Rhythm is everywhere.
It's just it's a constant thing. I think that's just in my blood. Rhythm is just in my blood. I think about it all day. It's just an everyday thing.
I can find rhythm in everything that I do.
Rhythm is everywhere.
Everything that I see, everything around me has some kind of rhythmic composition.
Rhythm is everywhere. You just have to be aware.
I think a lot of things happen when you're not really conscious about it.
When you're in tune, like with that type of stuff, those are things you just catch, like.
So you're always absorbing without really thinking about it.
I think rhythm is a direction, and rhythm is a compass point, and rhythm dictates what's happening around it.